Howdy, it's me, the new normal, Manic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system located underneath the Art Villa found in the jungles of the Midwest. So, normal doesn't mean I remember anything. Even though I've repeated, never mind. Okay, what's wrong? Why are you normal? It happened over about past couple of years, anyway. I'm just feeling very much more normal. I'm kind of enjoying it, actually. Being a little bit more normal. I'm coming to you with a stack of records. Manic Mark, how can you call that a stack? Well, if it's more than one record, in this case there's three, it's a stack. You have a top and a bottom, and a middle. If it's just two records, you have a top and a bottom, but you don't have any middle. Can you call that a stack? Oh, I have to leave these questions up for minds more mathematically inclined to solve spatial relationship problems than me, Manic Mark. Okay, go on. It was 12 o'clock when I got to Half Price Books, okay? First of all, why are you wearing your new spiffy vest? Well, this is a DeWalt safety vest. That's right. It's got a little reflective stuff on it. It's a high-vis yellow, and it's got pockets and stuff. It's the higher end of the safety vest, I think. Anyway, I researched safety vest, ear protection, and hard hats extensively this week. There's a reason for it, because they're working on a place that I work at. There's a big construction thing going on there, and we're just working there as part of the museum staff. We just work naked, okay? We wear no protection, including shoes and gloves and high-vis safety vests. And to get to things, we climb ladders oiled with olive oil. And, no, we don't. But in the modern age of safety first, the government will find it the hell out of people and companies. Why? Well, because they just need money to run their departments, first of all. And second of all, there's probably some reason. But that leads me to my other point, which is whatever you have, whatever kind of safety device you have, you're going to have an accident related to the safety device. Okay, they come up with all these safety regulations and devices based on, you know, accident data, right? But then when they enact a thing, there's less deaths, but it's not because the people aren't wearing the safety thing or doing a safety thing. It's because they are wearing a safety thing. So they're dying because of the safety thing, not because of something else they happen to be doing at the moment, which could be anything, okay? Well, that's a problem too, because then, well, if you're running a power saw and cut off your finger, nobody has that I know of. Has the thing, the sensor, that when it starts to slice through the hot dog, the blade explodes, breaks up. You ruin the blade and the sensor, and it costs a lot of money. That's why they just sacrifice the finger, because the finger is not worth as much as the exploded saw. You can always get another finger. All right. So we worked for about 4 days before somebody yelled at us, said, "Hey, here you are in a construction zone and you're not wearing a construction zone stuff that you got to wear." Well, nobody told us anything, right? So the security came down and they handed out temporaries. You can't keep it. You got to always return it. And I don't want to be responsible for thinking about returning, and I just want to go to work and have my thing. So, not too expensive. I bought the DeWalt safety vest. This is the extra large, not the XXL. There's some discussion on in the comments about, hey, I wear a 2XL and this, it was a tent on me, and thought, ooh, I don't want a tent, because if you're leaning over and doing something, you'll get your tent caught in the saw and drag your head down in. See? That's what I'm saying. So I got the XL, and I don't have the hat yet. So I had to wear the hard hat. So I wore the hard hat in one day. By the time we got yelled at, we had one day to wear the safety stuff. I didn't have the vest, so I have a high-vis yellow shirt, and nobody yelled at me for not having the vest on, because my shirt was as loud. No, it wasn't a Hawaiian shirt. why didn't I think of that? If I had worn it, I wouldn't want to ruin it. That's why. There's a logical reason why I didn't wear a Hawaiian shirt, because I want to ruin it, because all my Hawaiian shirts are fabulous, and I kind of, you know, keep them safe and nice. But anyway, if I had, they probably would have said, where's the vest? I'm saying, you got to be kidding. Look at this shirt. This shirt's screaming. No, it makes me want to go on vacation. I don't like that. Wear the vest. That makes me think that, you know, you're working, because the vest is kind of fun. It's kind of like a modern Hawaiian shirt, actually. So my other point is, if everybody has the headlights that turn on during the day, oh, well, then everybody will be able to see everybody driving. Then people are just going to get used to headlights being on during the day. It's the same thing with the high-vis vest and the high-vis emergency vehicles, all right? Okay, you know, it used to be red. Oh, nobody could see the dark, kind of the red. But the high-vis, oh, there it is. Well, it was just because it was new, right? So you've got all these people wearing high-vis flashy vests, and you're just like another pea in a pod. Nobody, you don't stand out any more than you. So you know what I'm saying? It's like the sameness. So I wore the hat, and I was thinking, I bought some cheap ones, okay, because I wanted to put things on them. I thought, well, I could wear one of my cheap hats with the deer antlers on it, but that would probably get caught in something too, and it would be a safety security issue, and I would get in trouble for that. So I did wear the and then I have another one it's yellow, and I weighed them both, and the yellow one was a little more than a pound, but I felt a little bit more comfortable, and the white one was just about a pound. But at 12 o'clock, my neck was not feeling too good. It was, you know, a pound of weight on your head by the end. So then I got yelled at lunch, where's your hat? I'm sitting there, nobody's in the room, I'm sitting there eating my lunch, they yell at me, where's your hat? And I think the guy was just jerking me off, but probably not. And I didn't think, I saw him get up on the ladder. I said, hey, aren't you more than 6 feet off the ground, and where are your safety glasses? So there, you know, I mean, you know, violations all around me, and I get yelled at. So where was I going with that? Okay, so I wore the hat and the glasses. I forgot to look for them. The glasses are slightly tinted. They're just perfect for most normal situations, but since we work in the dark, I need to get some glasses that are like completely crystal clear safety glasses. And I don't want the cheap ones. Of course, no. Manic Mark always goes high class. Something with lenses that won't scratch up instantly. That's it. All right. Something that works. Oh, so I got the hat that's on the way. For an hour, I researched hard hats. You know, the thing of it is, you think with the internet, you would just have clear solutions, answers. Like type in lightweight hard hat. Well, lightweight is a relative term, of course, because they're all can be construed, perhaps, as lightweight protective headgear. But there was no discussion on, like, what's the lightest weight hard, physically the lightest hard hat, which you think there would be, all right, since the neck, you know, trying to keep the hard hat up. And some of them didn't even have the weight of the item, okay, but many of them did, just as a matter of course, I guess, in trying to describe the specs of the item. All right, so but there was some talk on comfort, meaning not like the weight, uncomfortableness from the weight, but the comfortableness of just wearing the hard hat itself. There's the four-point system, which means basically your inner liner attaches to four spots on inside the hat, the hard hat, and or six-point, which is six spots, two in front, two in back, and two in the sides. Plastic versus more of a breathable cloth-like material. All right, so the six-point suspension system with the ratchet in the back is going to increase the cost of the hat, you know, so which they can range. There was carbon fiber. That was the thing. Carbon fiber, I think everybody thinks, well, carbon fiber, it's just going to be harder. So you're going to be more protected. But you would think it'd also be lighter. But then nowhere could I find, for the carbon fiber hats, which are $50, any kind of weight data. And then the other strong, they're still making some metal, and there's like a metal fiberglass sort of blend, which over a pound, heavier, okay, I guess, in some instances. But most of them are the plastic, the high-impact plastic, okay? So the one I got on the way has that ratcheting system. It looks comfortable, and it's 4 ounces. It's like 12 ounces, maybe 12 and a half ounces, somewhere around in there. So we're going to give that a shot. Boy, this is exciting. Once again, it's exciting. Why? Well, Saturday, last week we had the migraine, and this week it's the sore throat. That, you know, it's the never-ending, you know. And I joked about, you know, the doctor hobby. Well, went to the doctor in the box today because of the sore throat. At least you didn't have a migraine, but in bed now. So here we are, down here in the basement, enjoying the Saturday. Tomorrow is going to be very busy because tomorrow is going to be the classic, going to be kind of nice, not going to be working, need to winterize the house, and that could seriously take me all day if I could remember everything I need to do, get done. There's going to be other warm days, but few and far between, storm windows, like plug up holes in the garage, probably clean the lawnmowers. It may be early for that. I mean, wait until the middle of October sometime to do that. You clean the spark plugs. Does anybody have a spark plug cleaner? Here's a helpful tip for me, the helpful safety oriented Manic Mark, the new helpful normal Manic Mark. Buy a spark plug cleaner. What the hell? I'll just show it to you. It's right here. So what does the normal person do? The normal person says, oh, I've used my lawnmower for 5 years and it doesn't run anymore. What could possibly be wrong with it? Let's take it in and let the professional service people deal with it. Well, that's one way. The second way is, oh, well, I know how to take care of my problem. It's got to be the spark plug. It's always the spark plug. That's the issue. Take the spark plug out. Oh, it's dirty looking. Let's put a new one in, right? Or every year you can clean your spark plug. Some, if you own a chainsaw, that's where it really counts, because you got to clean a chainsaw after each heavy use, which includes, in my opinion, cleaning the spark plug. So here it is. This is a spark plug cleaner. It's basically graphite, powdered, abrasive, goes into the bag. You hook it onto your air compressor. I would recommend a 3.5 horse air compressor just for airflow, enough airflow. It's got a button on it. You push and the abrasive flies around. You put the spark plug in this hole and it cleans it off. So you save buying spark plugs, and or if you don't have one, you just have a clean spark plug. Your old spark plug's clean. You don't need to go out and get one, or you can wait and go out and get one later on. Anyway, so one of those aren't banned by the Spark Plug Association, if you think about it. Because you could get the graphite in your eye when you're cleaning it. It could be a safety hazard. Unless you're wearing your safety glasses, then you foil that. It's a good thing I'm not a lawyer. I sit up and think about these things all day long. Oh, it's like drinking coffee today, tonight. There's coffee on special. I go to Meijer's, there are a lot of things on special. But there's these soups that come in pouches. Wild Alaska, I think it's. And they were on special, like 75% off, but they were still $1.50 or something like that. Oh, because of the fish, which they're no more fish, so when they find one, they chop it up and they mix it up with other stuff. And so as soup, because they're trying to spread out the last few fish that are left in the ocean, and that's why the soup's very expensive. So I bought a bunch of those last week, and I went back, and this is like nobody. Oh, the $4, like if it wasn't 75% off, then it would be like $4, $5, $6. Nobody wants a little pouch of, you know, chopped up fish bits for $5 or $6. And they hardly wanted them because when they put the items out, the old people swoop in, me included, swoop in, and they're just grabbing, you know. But there were still some of that those fish pouches there, and I got a couple more for myself. Now I find this interesting because I'm the kind of guy, I like to buy, when I see something it's discounted, I need to buy a lot of it, right? Okay, and then I know I'm going to use it later, but it's like that. I think I should just leave one because it would be greedy to take all of the fish bits pouches this time around. So I didn't take all of them, I just took a few. And I almost took all, there was boxes of dented chicken broth that were marked down 75% off, okay? I took four of those, and there were eight of them. I would just feel greedy, you know? I would use all of them, but I feel greedy, so I just can't take all of them. If it's just one sitting on the shelf, I look around, and I just take it, you know, because my sense of, you know, the universe revolves around me is more important, you know, as it is for all of us. So you just take the box, the dented box of chicken broth, marked down 75% off for yourself. Really, whether anybody sees you or not, it doesn't matter. You just grab it and run. And or you can go to the store like, oh, it's the apocalypse, you know, with that mindset. And get out of my way. Get out of my way. Give me that fish broth, old woman. Jerk it out of her hand. So there was, what else was that? The discount thing that I got. I picked up something else. There was some toilet paper, which I needed. It was on the bottom shelf, and there was a lady's cart in front of me. I think, oh, well, that could be like the really thick triple panel paper. Nobody should get that. If you get that, it's just going to like turn into cement in your sewer, and you're going to have to pay big money to ream out your sewer pipes. Don't buy that really comfortable toilet paper. Just get the really thin stuff that your finger goes through. You know, that was, why'd you have to go there? Sorry about going there. When are you going to do records? I don't know. There's only three of them in the stack. I can do them at any time. I didn't think I was going to sit here and talk all this time. I came down here with nothing in my head. And when I leave, there'll be nothing in my head. But in between, things sort of form, and here you go. So I'm at Half Price Books. And it's 12 o'clock, and everything's going to be picked through, if there is anything to pick through at all. And there's this young, and I go, oh, there's nobody. Then it's like, oh, God, please don't let anybody be in my way, you know? So I don't go in with the apocalypse mindset, like, get out of the way, I got to get my records. It's the apocalypse, it's the last chance. And there's a young girl there, and how do they fit into those pants? That's what I want to know. The pants are so tight. They have to be stretchy pants, even if they're jeans. They got to be stretchy because they're just so tight. It looks so uncomfortable. I can't believe it. But they're probably not. There's some sort of scientific miracle fabric that they put into these pants that are too tight. They're still comfortable. It can't just all be, you know, like fashion. She was sitting on the floor. I mean, my God, who could do that in pants that are too tight? I couldn't. She's there with her mother, I figure out. So I go around them, I pull a chair up, and I sit down, because I think I'm not in their way, but I am kind of in their way, because they were kind of looking. I think they were headed over to where I sat down at, but I don't care. At this point, I've got a chair. They took the rolling stools out. Those little red stools, they're about a foot, 18 inches high, and when you're off of them, they have little springs, and the wheels come up, so you can kind of like roll the thing around, or if you're sitting on it, you can spring up. Do you know what the stools I'm talking about? They're all gone. A month ago, they all disappeared. Like, when I check out, I said, I missed the stools. And she goes, well, we're selling them. There are a few behind the counter. So I don't really want to buy one, but I miss them when I'm here because they're great for sitting on, and you've got all those records down at the bottom. What are we supposed to do about that? She went, well, yeah. I said, oh, somebody stood on the goddamn stool and fell off it. Now there's an effing lawsuit somewhere. She's like, well, you know. Lawyers, they sit at home. And you think about ways to do things, like make any, maybe not at home, maybe they have an office. Unless they're at home and they have a home office. Then they're probably sitting in their home office. But maybe they sit there when they're watching football or any time, like on the job. How can I make some money today by causing, you know, problems for someone, solving problems for somebody, but causing problems for somebody else at the same time? All right, so they're there. They're sitting down and they're looking. I'm like, oh, what are they looking for? Because the first thing through your head is like, oh, all the good records will be gone because they'll have snatched them all up. But then I hear like, well, here, Mom, here's a Barbara Streisand. Like, oh, Barbara Streisand. And she goes, well, Mom, tell me something you want me to look for. And I look for it. And her mother goes, Air Supply. I'm like, so what did she pull out? Oh, Mom, look, here's a Dean Martin. Her mother like twitters a little bit. Oh, and she starts to get a little bit excited about the whole experience. And the girl says, Mom, don't weird out on me. And I'm sitting right there. I heard that. Weird out. You know, you're both looking for Barbra Streisand Air Supply albums, and you're worried, you know, that your mother looks like she's weirding out. You're wearing the too tight, ill-fitting pants, and you're pulling out, you know, Barbra Streisand, and you're giving your mother, it's like, what are you doing? It's kind of like the heroin problem. You have a huge heroin problem in town. Records are not like heroin. No, they're not. Or are they? if you're normal, would you buy this many records? That's the thing. I decided that many of my compulsions were due to just being not normal. So I've given up almost all my compulsions, almost including records, because, you know, I don't go to the thrift shops anymore. So then you think, oh, well, you're just depressed because you don't like, that's the thing. That's what I wanted to talk about, depression. Because they say, if you give up all the things you love to do, then you're depressed. Or are you depressed because you're trying to keep up with all the things you love to do? That's my question. If you're compulsive and try to keep up with all that stuff, that creates anxiety, an anxiety compression complex, a roller coaster, manic. But if you don't have any compulsions, you're not driven to go feed the compulsions, and therefore you face a lot less anxiety and letdown, which could lead to depression. You say, oh, I didn't find any records today. I'm so depressed. I'll have to go again tomorrow. There'll be a chance. Oh, no, there are no records. Oh, I feel so down in the dumps and blue. The same thing can go with anything. Oh, antique toasters. Oh, I'm on eBay. Oh, there's no antique toasters. You get one in the mail, it's like, oh, well, they could have packed that better. That example's broken now. I hate this compulsion. Right, okay, on to the records. Oh, God, I can hardly lift the stack. Starting with a record that I passed up last week at Half Price, Full Price, Super High Price Books. It's like, no, you just can't feed your compulsion the way you always have. Oh, I couldn't help myself. Why? Because I finally looked at, it's not printed on the cover anywhere. I pulled the record out and it's a local press. It's a local Queen City album manufacturer. A polka band. All right, I just picked it. It's autographed. It's got to be worth $1,000. Local polka band, Queen City album, probably in the 70s. Oh my God. Anyway, it'll be fun to put on the blog. The second record I picked up was, I think, there last week too, and I didn't pick it up. But since I wanted to stack a record, which is three records, a top, a bottom, and a middle, I had to pick it up. So it's Blauer Himmel, Rooney Paulman, Lieder Schlager von der Südsee. It's a tropical Hawaiian record. Sunny Hawaii, Der Blue Himmel von Hawaii. I picked one up without, it had a guy on a cover, maybe just because this cover looked kind of boring to me, I left it. But yeah, the Germans, they, you think all they wanted to do was go to Russia, there was, you know, that was the vacation spot, you know, to just go take over Russia so they can vacation. But no, they probably would have invaded the Hawaii Islands, given a half a chance, you know, for the crystal clear blue waters, the fishing, and the girls in the grass skirts. Makes sense to me. Last but not least, I think I have it, but I don't think I have it in the Grand Awards version. It's I Want to Be Happy, Cha-Cha's. That's kind of depressing. I want to be happy. I went to depressing, horrible Cha-Cha's. They're all the other records are like that, the Latin records. So I just want a happy Cha-Cha. Can't you just give me a happy Cha-Cha? Okay. Enoch Light said. So, but it's a colorful, interesting color palette. On this record, like, and there's no, I can never quite get the timeline for the Grand Awards before, after, because like at the same time he had to be running Command and Grand Awards. There had to be overlap. Grand Awards perhaps being a spinoff budget label. But I don't know if I've been able to. I don't remember why, because my brain only holds so much, just as your brain holds so much. And when you get older, it's harder to learn stuff because your brain's like, well, you've only got this much space left. Out of all this space, you've got this much space left. And you better not waste it remembering stuff that's not important. Because if you're going to fill up that last space, you're going to have to get rid of something and or not remember certain things that you probably would like to have remembered, like, never mind. It's time to go on to the musical sample. That wasn't a very exciting ending, was it? Well, you're not going to come up with an exciting ending, so just go on with the rest of the video. Yeah, I know I'm back. I had to cut that thing because when I went to process the video, I realized, so I was actually thinking upstairs rather. Never mind. Okay, that I forgot to talk about the main thing that happened this week. It's unbelievable that I forgot, but then again, this is what I had to wear all day. It was very uncomfortable. It was but the weight, I'm hoping the next one won't. Anyway, so, I thought I had Grover's disease, okay? I was a weed whacking a hillside, and there's some poison ivy over there. but for the most part, and I wear shorts, it's really hot. And it's just like coated with grass and whatever have you. Why? Because you're not wearing safety. Any kind of, anything, earplugs and you know, you safety glasses, of course. It's just weed whacking, all right. But it must be the time of year when poison ivy or something is really active. And there's patches of it over there, okay? I've never had a real issue with it. So I got some patches, you know, here and there, like, just don't itch them. If you don't start itching them, sometimes they just, you know, you can get by without. But then I notice I come home and there's these weird red specks on my feet and other parts of my body, and they don't itch. It doesn't itch. And then I'm like a pimply stuff here, then that doesn't itch. And I can't find anywhere online, although I spend a long time trying to find an image that says, hey, this is you, Manic Mark. And so I'm like at work, like, hey, everybody, I'm like, look at this and touch, feel this rash. See if, can you, have you ever felt a rash like this before? Just run your hand all up and down my rash. And I'm like, I'm kind of like, what the hell's going on? Because you think the parts that I had clothes on, like socks and other, you wouldn't have a rash. Like poison ivy just affects the, so I don't know what's going on. So finally, I find this link to this thing called Grover's disease, and the photograph looks just like what I got. The symptoms appear to be just like what I've got. And it says it's rare. It's rare, and it happens in men, older men like me, old like me, Manic Mark. Comes on quickly, which it did. Sometimes can affect the feet, but mostly the chest and the back, and it can be really itchy or not that itchy. All right, so I had the not that itchy form. And it can last up to or longer than 6 months. I'm like, oh Lord, 6 months with these little red specks. I go to yoga class and everybody moves to the other side of the room. You know, they don't want to come over here. Feel my rash. Come on, ladies. Just all this sweaty rash. Just feel. Nobody wants that. So I go to work and I announce that I have Grover's disease. And they're, what do you want? You know, workers' comp? I say, no, I'm just proud to have a rare disease. It's kind of cool. And then it's not life-threatening. And then it sort of faded away as fast as it came on me, you know, so that this morning at yoga class, there was, you had to look really hard. So the women kind of came back around me a little bit. Still didn't want to, you know, like, go ahead, just touch it. Touch the Manic Mark. Found out today the yoga instructor is half Danish and half Swedish. That's right. That's the end of the story about the, you know, you're probably, there was many people out there worried about me. Oh, not really. Every man for himself. Missed again, but that's just the reality of life. ¶¶